So the first thing we're going to do for this exercise is going to be to plot a simple sine function. And we're going to do this by first establishing 100 x values in series. And then using the Graphmapper tool in order to turn them in, create a sine function. And in order to use the Graphmapper tool, first we have to turn this series, which is from 0 to 99, into a series that goes from 0 to 1. And we're going to do this by remapping the domain. This is done using the remap numbers tool. And all it needs is the domain of the source, which in this case is again 0 to 99. You obtain this using the bounds component. Plug this into the source. The target is set by default to 0 and 1, which is what we want. And then just plug the values into the values input, and then you get the remapped series of numbers, which goes from 0 to 1. Now this can be used by the Graphmapper. And the Graphmapper, you can just right-click and select different methods of transforming the distribution of your original series. What we're going to choose here is sine. And you can move the curve to establish what you want. So now if we take the points creation component and use this as y values and this as x values, you'll see we'll obtain a very, very subtle sine curve. We actually want to read this a bit better, so we're going to modify the amplitude of our y values by inserting a multiplier. So that's something we can use. Now you'll notice this curve is quite smooth, and what we're interested in is looking at these y values and seeing how many different ones we have. You can take any series of numbers and find out how many unique values it has by creating a set. This is done using the create set component. This will show you only unique values within this set. However, in this case, if you just sample the number of values in this list, it'll say 100, because there are 100 unique values for y, which means that every single point has a unique y value. And we're going to try to reduce this number to something that might be manageable. So we're going to try to reduce it to 5 and see how this curve looks. So first we're going to create a number slider that we can use to define the number of individual indices that we want to create the sine curve with. Let's say 5. And we'll create a series from this. So this series goes from 0 to 4, but actually we want to remap it to the range of our y values so that it goes to the highest point in the amplitude of this curve. So what we do is, again, use the remap component take the source domain and take the target domain from here. And we get the target values that we're going to try to make each one of these points snap to. Now, the way we'll do this is we're going to test the difference of each of these y values to each of these five indexical values. And we'll just choose the smallest difference and use that to determine which index is used to replace this y value. In order to do this, we're going to have to graph all of these values so that we can then test them to each of these five. So we'll just do a simple subtraction. However, a subtraction will also give negative values. We're only interested in the distance from the closest index. So we're going to use the absolute value of this difference. And this eliminates all of the negative values. And then it's just a case of sorting these values and obtaining the smallest one. Which would be the first index. However, we don't want the difference. We actually want to use this sort component to sort our list of indices concurrently. So the output from A here is going to be our sorted indices. And when we take that, flatten it and use it to plot our points here. Then we're going to get a sine curve that's been rationalized to five individual y values. We can go back and change the number of values, and as we increase it, we see that the curve gains definition. And if we reduce it, the curve gets more and more blunt and difficult to discern. So this is what rationalization consists of. It's basically using the least amount of values or the least amount of complexity to get the desired effect. Let's use 7. However, this is still not as optimized as it could be, and I'll show you how. If you look at the list of indices that we're trying to map this curve to, you'll notice that it's essentially a linear list. That means that the difference between each index and the one before it and after it is always the same. If you plot this on a graph, it would show you a straight diagonal line. This distribution is not necessarily optimized for representing this curvature. So we want to be in control of the distribution of these values. In order to be a bit more clear about what this means, we'll try to visualize it. If we create a set from our list of y values, again, so it just gives you unique values, and use them to plot points along the y-axis. And then simply draw lines that are parallel to the x-axis. You'll see what this linear distribution means. This is all uniform. What happens when we repeat this for our original y values, the non-rationalized y values? You'll notice something interesting. The values tend to get denser at the tops and bottoms. That's because more of the curve is concentrated at the top and bottom. So essentially, by using a linear distribution, you're losing a bit of detail at the top and bottom. So we actually want to mimic this distribution in our indices. So how do we do this? We'll simply go back to our original list and apply the Graphmapper to it. So remember that the Graphmapper requires numbers in a domain of 0 to 1. So we have to use the remap numbers tool again. And for this, we have to read the bounds. And the target again is by default 0 to 1. So we apply the Graphmapper. And intuitively, we should also map them to a sine curve, because that's what this is. So we'll use these new values as a replacement for the originals. So this is a much better representation. I think if we go back and compare it with a linear relationship, which we can test here, there's a linear graph mapper type. You can see that the sine distribution is far better representation. So what we've done is we've taken a group of y values that were all completely unique. We created a fixed set of numbers, which we can then control. How many parts do we want to construct this sine curve representation with? We created a series of indices, and then we took each and every y value, found the closest index, and retrieved it to obtain our rationalized curve. And so using this, we're going to explore how we can construct a surface based on the same concept and control it in the same way.